Hey, so I just want to show you what to look for when you're going through these page reports and these speed reports. And if you're just using PageSpeed, it's not giving you the full picture. You also need to run it past GTmetrix, and you also need to cross-compare it with Pingdom tools, all right? If you're just doing PageSpeed, it's not going to give you enough information. You need to do all three. And the next caveat is that you need to make sure that the server location where it's tested from is closest to the server of the website or landing page. So in this case, I go to Pingdom Tools to have a look at what is taking up the most space on this page. The page has 5.4 megabytes of images. Now, normally a page in total, like the whole thing, should be like under 2 megabytes max, normally. Like across the hundreds of websites that I've seen, normally the best pages are under 2 megabytes. So the big winner or the quick win for me would be to decrease the image sizes. And then we can also take a look at GTmetrix, click on the waterfall, and then I have a look here. I'm just going to have a look at the images. And then we can see some of these images, they're not taking a lot, like the purple bit shows how long it takes for it to go through, but this more gray light nude color is telling us that it's been blocked for a long time, okay? So I would probably, like in between just looking at this and looking at this, I would condense the images and have a look at the images in general. So if you go to PageSpeed, you scroll down, you have a look, and you can see that this payload is 4 megabytes, over 4 megabytes. We can see these images. It's got JPEG, WebP file, so 3 images, 294 each. And then we can actually look into it. Right click. Let's open these to have a look. Okay, so it's a big image. Now what we have to do is go to the landing page and see where this image is. So from what I can see, it's just used in this background here. And if I scroll down the bottom, let's have a look. I can't see it being used anywhere else. So if the image is only needing to show this for aesthetic appeal, you don't really need it to be that large in file size, like because it's quite large in file size and it's in depth. So you can basically take this image, put it in Figma or put it in image resizer, resize it to something a bit smaller and then condense it again, use tiny PNG, all that kind of stuff, then re-upload it. Replace the image and delete the old one. Okay, that's what I would do in this case and do it with the other images to see how you go. And the next step, what we're going to do is we can see some of these preloaders in the back end for fonts and things like that. It's not preloaded yet. I want to show you how to preload it. Okay, so going into the back end, if we go into settings here, we can have a look at some of the settings for preloading things. So file optimization, I typically play around with HTML modifier. And CSS modify, but sometimes I don't use CSS because it can break things, so I don't always do that, okay? And in this case, it's been triggered a few times. I'm not sure if this is breaking anything. We'll have to find out. But anyway, let's go to the preload. In the preload settings, preload links, that's fine, but here it's got preload web font. And so if we go back to things like this one here, we can grab that link, copy the link there, paste it in here. We've got the link file there. Now, we might want to preload other things as well. So sometimes, and this is normally the case if you've got external Google fonts, you don't usually add fonts that you've already got on the server. Please do not preload the whole CSS. Yeah, you wouldn't want to preload the whole CSS file. So read all that kind of stuff first. But if we want to go into the waterfall again, so go back into here, go to fonts, and it actually gives you the preloaded font. So what we want to do is uncheck images, get the fonts only. And we've got these Typekit ones here. Okay, so what we can do is we can copy, or actually you're gonna have to expand that and copy the original here. And it's not actually, it's gonna actually truncate once you paste this in. So what that means is it's just basically going to, once you click save, that's going to probably change here. Okay, so give me a second. Let's wait for it to load. It's going to preload some of that stuff. So see what I mean by truncate? It just got rid of all that other fluff at the end. And we can continually do that across the rest of the ones that as seen here, down here. So you can start to load all the fonts from GStatic, all this kind of stuff, right? So that's what you'll need to do in terms of preloading and saving time on that end. And then you'll need to think about, can you combine images? When you're going through the web page, Can you actually combine certain like logos and things like that? I'm going to visit the page again. Okay, so going through the page, this needs to be left aligned. Let's go through the rest of it. Everything seems fine. So these ones here, right? Okay, they look like they have been compressed, which is great. I'm not sure, they need to make sure that they're using tiny PNG to compress them even further if they haven't already. These haven't been added. Oh yeah, they have. It's just slower. So there's a lot of, this is a image rich page, and these kind of pages, especially for portfolio, are very hard to get the page speed down just because there is so much being loaded. And since it's like one of those sales pages that you need, give me a second, I've got to answer that. Okay, where was I? So since these are sales pages and you need all the images really crisp and nice, and you can't have them grainy and pixelated because that might tank the deal or tank the person from even taking that next step with you, then sometimes it's very unavoidable to even compress a lot of the images. But you just look for clever ways in order to compress the images. Like, for example, you could, in theory, combine all these in one image, like pull them all into Figma, have them all as one image, and then pull that across. And you could cleverly, instead of having six images, you now have one image. The only issue is for the quality, right? And so you'd have to show a different one for mobile or different one for desktop. But those are just different clever ways that you can kind of bring that page speed down so that it's faster. So yeah. When you're going through everything like that, so when you're going through the waterfall, you're just looking at quick wins, and then from there, and you're like thinking, oh, how can I improve the page speed of this? Can I make this better? Google it. I mean, that's really the answer at the end of the day. Like, no one's going to come in and give you the answer. A lot of this stuff, there is no like rule book or playbook or a close companion that's going to give you all the answers. I mean, you could try ChatGPT, sorry. But even these, like when you're looking at these breeze, these are all caching issues inside of, this is to do with Cloudways, because breeze is part of Cloudways. But you, I mean, just Google that as well. See if that's avoidable, but I would just start with the images. Like when you're going through all those images, you can see that that's really the biggest culprit here. And then the scripts don't have a big, you know, they don't contribute a lot to the page speed here. So fix the images, see how, if you can bring that down, see if that improves the load speed, and give it tests. Sometimes you have to actually test the same page like 20 times, okay, or 30 times just to cross compare. So that's how you'd bring the page speed down. So anyway, if you've got any questions, let me know. Thanks.